My name is María Sánchez. I am co-founder and director of Estudio Urbano. It is a great honor to have been invited to present Ciudad Cayalá, a new extension of Guatemala City. Ciudad Cayalá is a new town in Guatemala that is being built according to traditional urban and architectural principles. It is situated on a plateau some 4 kilometers to the east of the historic center of Guatemala City. Planning began in 2002 when our firm Estudio Urbano invited worldwide recognized master planner Leon Grier to join the effort. After establishing the partnership, our team persuaded the landowner client to embrace our vision for a vibrant, humanist new development. Master planning started with a charrette in 2003. It was planned for 7 years before it started building. It is a large property, over 500 acres, surrounded by deep ravines, which were portioned into 4 interconnected urban quarters with different characters: Paseo Cayalá, Nogales, Socorro Bajo, and Socorro Alto. Each one consisting on several neighborhoods and connected by a 4-kilometer-long main street extending along a natural bridge. Also, a 103-acre green area on the west side of Paseo Cayalá has been retained as the largest ecological reserve in Guatemala City. The master plan offers a way of life that is greatly improved as compared to the typically disconnected, car-oriented developments around Guatemala City. Our proposal is the creation of a humane and hospitable urban environment that fosters a vibrant commercial and civic life and a strong sense of community and pride of place in its residents. The first phase of Cayalá's master plan broke ground in 2009 with the construction of Paseo Cayalá. This first urban quarter is designed around 4 principal streets converging on a main square. What is really interesting about Paseo is that we started to build the high street first, which was about 500 meters long, and it included a series of small blocks, a very rich network of public space, streets, mixed-use buildings with shops, apartments, workplaces, and the civic building. From the beginning, there was a strong sense of place, like it was always there. On the main square, we are now building the Church of Santa Maria Reina de la Familia, a sacred building which its dome and campanario mark in a very special way the center of the town. Public buildings and spaces are carefully integrated and connected to promote social interaction and reinforce a sense of community among the residents and visitors. All the streets and spaces are connected to a public promenade that offers breathtaking views of Guatemala City skyline and volcanic peaks on the horizon. The great range in size, configuration, and allocation of the building lots ensures programmatic and typological variety, architectural richness, and picturesque beauty. A consistently civic scale, use of a form of architectural vocabulary which is inspired with a passion for the form of our amazing architectural legacy and greater richness of materials, allows Paseo Cayalá public edifices such as Azaria Hall by Richard Economakis, the Market Tower by Leon Krier, and our design, the Church Santa Maria Reina de la Familia, to stand out against the surrounding buildings and serve as visual points of reference. Also, entrusted to different architects, these buildings are designed to be good architectural neighbors. They represent variety within unity and symbolize a hopeful collaborative design. Our advocacy of the use of natural materials and methods of lighting and ventilation and a reduced dependency on automobile have positively impacted the welfare of residents, the lifespan of buildings, and the economy of Cayalá, which has continued to grow. The intention has been to create a beautiful, secure place for Guatemalans to visit and enjoy for generations to come. As part of Paseo Cayalá, Estudio Urbano was commissioned to design the buildings of the residential neighborhoods of Ramblas, Nova, Beleza, and Olmos. These areas, which comprise a range of attractive housing options and landscape parks, were complete between 2014 and 2019. The new neighborhood of Lirios within the quarter of Paseo Cayalá was designed in response to the demand for the mixed-use housing near the center of town. The design process generated a new type of building, the Palacito, which addressed the client's density requirements while allowing the design of humanely scaled streets. The master planning and building designs are coordinated to allow for a continuous parking area beneath the streets and blocks. The result is a compact neighborhood, made up of insula, or small enclaves, which in turn are comprised of 5 to 7-story palacitos, connected by a pedestrian network of streets and plazas. Lirios saw its first enclave open in 2019, with five more expected to be completed soon. Following the success of Paseo Cayalá, the new quarters of Nogales, El Socorro Bajo and El Socorro Alto, are currently under design, with construction for the first neighborhoods expected to begin in 2022. A new bridge will connect Paseo Cayalá with Nogales to ensure continuity of the main street along the length of Ciudad Cayalá. The principle of mix of uses applied in the design of Paseo Cayalá has enabled the emergence of a strong, healthy public realm. I am very proud to say that our project has received numerous international awards for establishing a sustainable, safe, pedestrian-oriented urban environment that embraces Guatemala's unique architectural identity. Cayalá is an open city for an open society. It is an attraction for everyone, regardless of income, social class, age, religion, gender, or race. Our goal with the new city of Cayalá is to show a viable alternative for future development, one which will take more than a generation to develop, but we hope it will be successful with the support, love, and embrace from the people that is currently beginning to show. For our team, Cayalá is the physical proof that traditional architecture and urbanism can bring us closer to the ideals of order, courtesy, peace, respect, freedom, and contemplation of beauty. Engaging in contemplation, we raise our spirit to a vision that transcends our daily life. It gives us hope and confidence that we can strive to live a life of dignity and prosperity, a more responsible, more peaceful, and more meaningful life.